right, dear. You can stay for the weekend. Yeah, better come home and get some clothes, huh? All right, bye. That was Babs. She's going to stay at Franny's for the weekend. She sent her love to you.
Thanks, Dumplin. Boy, that was delicious grub.
Food.
I stand corrected. That was delicious food grub. Excuse me, Mom. I got to go over to Joyce. I left my books over there.
Now, will you come right back?
Okay. Need any help with the dishes, honey?
No, thanks, dear. You're sweet, though.
Well, if you do, just holler. Junior will be glad to pitch in.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Riley.
Who's that?
It's me, Waldo Benny. Now, don't you stir even a wee bit. I don't want to disturb you.
Oh, you ain't disturbed me, Waldo. I was just thinking.
Well, fine, then I think the perfect time. This morning I dashed off a little poem. You like poetry, don't you?
Oh, I love poetry. I must know 50 Burma shave signs by heart.
Oh, fine. Well, this is a different type of poem. You see, I feel the world today is losing sight of true values. People are getting cynical and bitter. We're forgetting the two most precious emotions.
What's that?
Love and friendship.
Love and friendship. Oh, you're so right. But not me. I love friendship.
Oh, fine. This poem symbolizes the need for people of all beliefs, of all faiths, and of all nations to live together in peace.
That's a very good poem.
Thank you. Now I'll read it for you. 55 pages, yes. It's all here. You ready, Mr. Riley?
Yeah, I'm ready.
There was a wise old owl who had a friend, a mouse. They lived within a hollow tree. Theirs was a happy house.
Very good point. An owl living with a mouse. Democracy.
Now, the mouse was very small, while the owl was much bigger.
Hiya, fellas. Mrs. Riley, can I borrow a couple of eggs?
Just stopped in to borrow a couple of eggs.
I see it.
Go ahead, Waldo.
Oh, well, I better start at the beginning so you don't lose the thread.
Yeah, pick up the thread.
There was a wise old owl who had a friend, a mouse. They lived within a hollow tree. Theirs was a happy house.
Who wants to hear that kind of stuff? We're living in hollow trees. Believe me, I suffered enough during the housing shortage.
Quiet, Gillis. This is a poem.
Go ahead, Waldo.
About love and friendship. The whole world. That's what I point out here.
It's a waste of time. The world can't fall in love with each other just like that. It's got to start in your own house first.
Like this.
Well?
Well, what?
This tie. This tie's worth every bit of $2. Ain't you going to ask me where I got it?
Why should I ask you where you got it?
What am I, a department store detective? Ha, ha, ha! Very humoresque. It might interest you to know, Riley, that my boy Egbert gave me this tie.
Fine. For your birthday. There was
it ain't my birthday. He gave it to me because he loves me. Because I'm a pal to him, that's why. My boy ain't going to grow up to be no juvenile delinquent. Because he and me is buddies. Coronies. But you and your poor junior, you're perfectly strangers.
My son and I are very close. Go ahead, Waldo.
There was a wise old owl who had a friend, a mouse.
Owls living with mice. Stop that communist propaganda. All I say is, you got to cultivate your boy in his early years.
My boy likes me fine.
Yeah? Does he ever give you any little presents like my egg boy gives me? I mean, unexpected presents.
Well, yeah.
See? That proves he don't care about you.
Presents don't mean anything. My son thinks the world of me. He always speaks very nice to me.
Well, naturally, the boy is polite to you. You're giving him free room and board, ain't you?
He likes me for my own sweet self. I'm sure of it. He never said anything about not liking me, did he, Walter?
Of course not.
All I mean is that love starts in the house, and a father can't take no chances.
My son and I are very good friends.
Mr. Gillis, here are your eggs.
Oh, thanks. Thanks very much. So, just remember, be a wise old owl, because there's a mouse in the house.
I don't remember writing it that way.
What's he talking about?
Oh, nothing, Peg. Something about Junior.
What about Junior?
It's nothing. That Gillis is a mental case. Junior likes me, don't he, Waldo?
Indubitably. Now, don't worry. You have a very devoted son.
not worried about anything. What have I got to be worried about?
There was a wise old owl who had a friend, a mouse. They lived within a hollow tree, and theirs was a...
Junior! Hi, Pop.
Gee, I'm glad you're home.
What's up?
Nothing, Junior, my boy.
Mr. Riley, I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, okay, Waldo. Oh, by the way, that was a very good poem.
Oh, thank you very much. Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Oh, wait a minute, Junior. I wanted to talk to you.
Anything wrong, Pop?
Oh, no. You know, I was just thinking of some boys I know. You know, offhand, like. And, I was wondering, who's your best friend?
Who's my best friend?
Yeah, you know, like, well, if you were in a jam, who would you go to?
Oh, well, you know the answer to that.
Sure, I know it, but I want to hear you say it.
Well, Mom, of course.
Well, your mother ain't anything to knock, but I mean, well, if you had something to tell somebody, you know, and you couldn't tell her, then who would you tell?
Well, then I'd tell Egbert Gillis.
You don't get me, Junior. Now, suppose you couldn't tell Egbert Gillis, you couldn't tell your mother, and you couldn't tell your sister. Now, who else would you tell that you love, that you know loves you?
Oh, I get you now.
Sure you do. Who?
Well, I couldn't say it right to your face, Pop.
Oh, I know it's a little embarrassing. You don't have to say it to my face. I'll turn my back.
Who?
Well,
my girl, Marilyn Morris.
Marilyn Morris?
Yeah. Hey, that reminds me. I gotta go wash up. I'm taking her to the movie tonight.
Some boy I got likes girls.
Oh, Pop.
Yes, Junior? Is there something you wanted to tell me? Something you forgot to tell me?
Yeah, there is something I forgot.
I knew it. Tell your old father.
I forgot to ask for my allowance.
Here it is.
Gee, an extra quarter. Gee, thanks, Pop. I'm late for school. So long, Mom.
Bye, dear.
Come on, Pop.
Wait a minute, Junior. Before you go... Well, what am I doing?
Oh, well, go ahead and whistle if you want to whistle.
I didn't want to whistle, Junior. Go ahead to school.
So long.
Now, Peg, do you see how much Junior loves me?
Well, after all, the boy's growing up. He's too old to kiss you.
He's not too old to kiss that Marilyn, though.
He's a girl. You can't treat Junior like a baby. He'll be 14 on Sunday.
Peg, is Sunday his birthday?
Oh, Riley, don't tell me you forgot the date.
But it can't be Sunday, Peg. He was born on a Monday. I remember, because that day I did the washing and you took it easy.
Riley, he was born on Monday, but this year his birthday falls on Sunday.
Oh. Peg, I got a great idea. I'm going to run a big surprise party for Junior. That ought to change his mind about me.
Junior loves you. You don't have to go to all this trouble.
But it's no trouble at all. All you do is write out some invitations, invite everybody, and then you hang up some nice decorations, and then you make about 5 pounds of cookies. Then the day of the party, Waldo Binney will come over and move around the furniture so we'll have more room. Don't mind the trouble at all.
I can see why. All right, I'll help with the party, but you better talk to Junior first.
Oh, no, Peg. This has got to be a surprise.
Oh, but you...
Please, Peg, don't argue. My head's made up. Now, promise me you don't tell Junior.
All right, I promise.
Atta girl. This'll really do it. Yes, sir. That Junior will know now that I ain't just a man that married his mother. I'm his father.
Goodbye, Goodbye, dear. I'll get you lunch.
Oh, thank you.
Happy birthday, Junior.
Oh, that's so well put.
Hey, ain't it a beauty?
Oh, it's fine,
it's
dear.
It's beautiful.
Now, Peg, is everything ready? We ain't got much time.
Yes, dear. Don't be nervous. The kids won't be here for 2 hours yet. There are 12 of them coming.
Oh, that's great. Waldo, did you get the ice cream?
Yes, Mr. Riley. 6 quarts. It's in the icebox.
Peg, make all the sandwiches and hide them. He'll be home from Sunday school any minute now, and we don't want him to catch on.
Well, you better put this somewhere.
Yeah, that's right. I'll hide it. I'll hide it in the coat closet.
Good. Be careful of the frosting.
Okay.
Hello, Pop.
Here, hold it for a minute, will you, Julie? Junior, what are you doing home?
Well, Sunday school let out early. What's in the box?
It's nothing. It's just a little cake.
Cake?
Yeah, I was passing a bakery shop and I felt the urge for a mouthful of cake.
That cake must be a foot high.
Well, I got a big mouth.
No, Junior.
What's this? Happy birthday to Junior. Pop, what's the idea?
Well, I might as well tell you. Can you keep a secret?
Well, sure.
I'm running you a surprise party this afternoon. Don't tell a soul.
Surprise party? For me?
Ain't I wonderful?
Oh, Pop, what'd you have to go and do that for?
Well, Junior, it's your birthday. How many times are you born?
Oh, well, you should have asked me. Maybe I got other plans for today.
All right, but you can break them for your father.
Well, no, I can't. I mean, I could, but... Well, okay.
Well, okay. Thanks very much.
Oh, gee, Pop, you don't see...
No, that's okay. I see. I see too much.
You don't understand, Pop.
I understand, Junior. You don't have to apologize. After all, I can't blame you for feeling like you do about me. You didn't ask for me to be your father. It was my own idea. Maybe that's why you cried so much when you were a baby.
Oh, Pop, don't talk like that.
Listen, Junior, you don't have to feel bad about this. I don't feel bad. After all, you should be cheerful. This is your birthday. Many happy returns to the day.
Thanks, Pop.
I can't understand why Junior isn't here yet. Hello? Who? Oh, well, that's too bad. Yeah, I hope you're better soon. Goodbye.
Who's that?
Willie Coogan. He can't come to the party. He's in bed with the measles.
Oh, the poor lad. Measles make you feel miserable. All blotchy.
Better off than I am. Hello? You have? Both of you? Gee, I'm sorry. Well, I hope you get better soon. Goodbye. Hey, the Bailey twins.
Not the measles.
Yeah.
Oh, that's very strange. First Willie Coogan and then the Bailey twins. And they were all supposed to come to the party. I'm afraid this can mean just one thing.
I'm afraid it does.
You're right. An epidemic.
Riley, who are you calling?
The Board of Health.
Oh, no, dear.
Oh,
don't...
you better not, Mr. Riley.
I'm surprised at you. This is my duty as a citizen.
But, Riley, you...
Hello, Health Department.
Hello, Board of Health. This is Chester A. Riley, 1313 Blueview Terrace. I got an epidemic for you.
An epidemic?
Yeah, the measles. It's all over town. It's breaking out like a rash.
That's impossible. All contagious cases are reported to us.
Oh, well, these are new cases. I know the kids myself. Willie Coogan and the Bailey twins.
The Bailey twins? That's a laugh. I'm their father.
Their father? You certainly got a gruesome sense of humor.
My boys haven't got the measles. I just dropped them off at a party 15 minutes ago.
That's funny. They ain't at my house.
Your house? They're going to a party at Barton Hawker's house. Matter of fact, all the boys in their class were invited.
Oh. Oh, I see. Oh, thank you. Cancel the epidemic. Hey? Nobody's coming to Junior's party. I guess the measles was just to cover them up.
I guess so.
They're all going over to Barton Hawker's party. And after all our preparations, 6 quarts of ice cream.
Have you ever seen 6 quarts of ice cream when it all starts to melt at once? It can get quite gooey.
Nobody's coming to Junior's party. It ain't fair.
Oh, we'll be here, dear. Now, don't you worry. We'll have a nice, quiet little party all by ourselves.
It'll be fun. You know, it's different.
Yeah, you're right. It will be different. Who needs those kids anyway? And maybe this will show Junior that I'm his real friend. Hello?
Hello, Mr. Riley. This is Marilyn Morris. Is Chester there?
Chester? Hey, Peg, do we know any Chester? Oh, Marilyn, you mean Junior. Well, he ain't here now, but we're expecting him any minute. Is there anything I can do for you?
Well, he's taking me to Barton Hawker's party, and he's late, and...
Junior's going to... He's going... No, he wouldn't. He couldn't. He wouldn't.
Mr. Riley, please stop shouting. When you see Junior, please tell him that I... Oh, never mind. He just walked in. Goodbye.
Riley, what's wrong?
Mr. Riley, you're all trembly.
Hey, Junior ain't coming to his own party.
What?
He's taking Marilyn to the other party.
Oh, no, Junior wouldn't do such a thing.
He's at her house now.
Oh, dear.
I think I'll take a walk.
Oh, no, dear, you better stay inside. It looks like it might rain.
That's good. Maybe a little water on my brain might help. To tell you the truth, Gillis, there is something eating at my brain. It's about my boy.
Hope it ain't anything serious.
Well, never mind.
My turn. What about your dear boy?
Well, you see, his birthday's today. He's 14. And I thought it was my duty as a father.
Yeah, yeah?
Never mind.
My turn.
Wait a minute. Didn't you just go?
Oh, now, don't mix up the game just because you're mixed up about your boy.
You'd be mixed up, too, if your son had no respect for you.
Riley, for years, I've been telling you how to bring that kid up. And do you ever say thanks? No. You insult me. My turn.
I think your own son would show up at his own party. I don't think he likes me.
What do you mean he don't like you? He hates you.
He does not hate me, Gillis.
Then why ain't he here?
Well,
my turn. I'll tell you why. Because you ain't a pal to him, that's why. You ever sit down and help him with his homework? No. You ever go on hikes with him? No. He likes football. You ever take him down the sidewalk in the front of the television store and watch a game with him? No. That's why he don't like you. Your turn.
Gee, I didn't realize that I've neglected him.
That's it. Jim. Sally, I'm your best friend. So I'm going to tell you something that even your best friend won't tell you. Your Junior's growing off of you. And you might as well face it.
Hi, Pop. Junior. What are you doing home?
Why, I came to my party.
You did? But I didn't expect you. I mean, what a surprise.
Well, jeepers, you didn't think I wouldn't show up for my own party that my very own father gave me.
Oh, Junior, my baby.
Oh, Pop.
I'm sorry. Congratulations, son.
Thanks, Pop.
Well, how about that, Gillis? I gotta go home.
Congratulations, Junior. I was wrong, Riley. I'm glad.
Gee, thanks, Gillis. Come over after for a mouthful of cake. I'll save you a candy.
Oh, thanks. Happy birthday.
Gee, son, you sure made me happy.
Well, jeepers, you didn't think I wouldn't show up for my own party.
Oh, of course not. It never entered my mind. There it is, son.
Gee, Pop. Gosh, Pop, you know, you kind of put me on the spot not telling me about the party and all. Marilyn said I had to take her to Barton Hawker's party.
Oh, I see. Well, where is Marilyn, Junior? Bring her in.
We're through. She went to Barton's party alone. But I can have my own party without her.
Junior, I got something to tell you. Nobody else is coming to your party either. They're all going to the other party.
Nobody's coming? Nobody?
There's gonna be nobody here but just you and me.
Some friends I got.
Don't blame your friends, Junior. They're too young to know what friendship is.
I guess you're the only real friend I got, Pop.
Don't say that, Junior, or I'll...
Nobody's coming.
Don't feel too bad about it, Junior.
I don't feel bad. Who needs those guys anyway?
Yeah, who needs those guys? We can have fun just by ourselves. Just you and me, Junior.
Sure, just you and me.
Yeah. Let's start having fun. Blow out the candles, Junior.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Come on, Junior, stop blubbering and blow.
I am blowing. I threw some of the icing off the cake.
See, is it, Junior? Junior, did you make a wish when you blew out the icing?
Yeah. I wish somebody'd come to my party.
Junior, please don't cry.
I ain't crying. Don't you cry.
I'm not crying.
We can go back to that Maryland if she keeps crawling on her hands and knees.
Had a boy, son. Shake on that shit.
Junior! Junior, where are you?
Pop! It's Marilyn! Wait a minute, Junior. Stop dragging me.
Oh, Junior, I was wrong. I should have come to your party. Will you ever forgive me?
Gee, sure I will, Marilyn.
Wait a minute, Junior. You just said...
I remember, Pop. Golly, of course I forgive you, Marilyn.
Oh, Junior, I'm so glad.
But, Junior, we just shook hands.
Mr. Riley, will you please refrain from trying to influence Junior? After all, we have an understanding.
Marilyn's right, Pop. Junior is 14.
When he's 18, we'll be engaged.
Okay. Come on in and we'll cut the wedding cake. I mean, the first thing.
Where's your knife, Pop?
Here it is.
Riley! Junior, you're here.
We've been looking all over for you.
What do you mean, worrying your father like this?
Oh, Peg, calm down. Everything turned out fine. It's Junior's birthday. What are we waiting for? For
he's a jolly good fella. For he's a jolly good fella. For he's a jolly good fellow.
And so is his lovable Pop.